talk about the emergency management of high blood pressure. High blood pressure in the emergency department is divided into two major categories: symptomatic versus asymptomatic high blood pressure. Asymptomatic high blood pressure is that which, although elevated, is not causing any symptoms. Asymptomatic high blood pressure rarely requires treatment in the emergency department, regardless of the level of the blood pressure elevation. If the emergency doctor does decide to treat asymptomatic high blood pressure, it is not the purpose to decrease the blood pressure in the emergency department. So usually, oral blood pressure medicine is used, and you are discharged home with an elevated blood pressure. This blood pressure will decrease over the next few days, and you will need to follow up with your primary care doctor to continue to monitor your medications and your blood pressure. Symptomatic high blood pressure, however, does require treatment in the emergency department. Symptomatic high blood pressure means that you have some kind of symptoms. That could be headache, lightheadedness, chest pain, trouble breathing, but could be as severe as kidney failure, heart attacks, congestive heart failure, etc. The emergency medicine workup of elevated high blood pressure will attempt to define if this is just symptomatic or emergent high blood pressure elevation. We will do this by getting blood work, EKG, sometimes even CAT scans to look for strokes. If we define that this symptomatic high blood pressure is indeed causing end organ damage symptoms, you will probably need to be admitted to the hospital to control your blood pressure and further manage your blood pressure elevation. The attempt of the emergency room doctor will be to bring your blood pressure down by only 30% of the mean arterial blood pressure. That means we're not trying to get that blood pressure normal, but rather to decrease it to a better level. Check your blood pressure every day, usually in the morning hours when your stress level's low and you're still laying in bed. This will be probably the most significant blood pressure measurement you can take, and keep a log of your blood pressures. So when you communicate with your primary doctor, we have a clear data of your blood pressure measurements. If you were prescribed blood pressure medicine, take it as indicated and do not skip any doses. Avoid stimulants like caffeine, soda, decongestants, tea, and so on. If you're overweight, try to start a weight loss program. Start an exercise program, as this will also help decrease your blood pressure. Try to decrease the amount of salt in your diet. Don't add any extra salt. Try to decrease your stress level. Stress is a very important factor in elevated blood pressures. And if you smoke, try to stop smoking. If you need help finding a way to quit, call your doctor and ask him for advice. Do return to the emergency department immediately if you experience any of the following: chest pain or trouble breathing, ringing in your ears or nosebleeds. If you experience any neurological symptoms, a severe headache, numbness or tingling of your hand, weakness of your arms, any trouble with speech, as these could be symptoms of an evolving stroke due to your high blood pressure.